Want to get the best performance out of Baldur's Gate 3 for your PC? Here is a complete optimization guide just for you. Before we move forward, do us a favor by subscribing to our channel and liking this video. It's free and helps us a lot. We do tons of research trying to find the working solutions for you. Your little support will help us continue making solution videos for you and others. Now, let's get started. Method 1. The first thing you need to do is change the in-game settings. Run Baldur's Gate 3 Launcher. Beside the play option, you will see two options, Vulkan and DirectX 11. If you are using an older GPU, then pick DirectX 11. If it's a newer gen model, select Vulkan. Now click on play to run the game. After the game launches, click on options. Next, select the video tab. First, click on the full screen display option and select the display that is connected to the graphics card. Next, set the resolution to native resolution of your monitor. Set display mode to full screen. Next, disable VSync. Check the frame rate cap box and set the frame rate cap slider to 240. Next, scroll down and set the model quality to medium. If you're using a 40 series or equivalent GPU, then you can set it to high without having much difference. Next, set the instant distance to low. Set the texture quality to medium or high if you have at least 4 GB of VRAM. Else, set it to low or very low. Set the texture filtering to anisotropic X16. If you don't have a GPU and running it on your integrated graphics, then set it to X2 or X4. Next, uncheck light shadows. Set shadow quality and cloud quality to low. Set the animation LOD detail to medium. If you have an NVIDIA graphics card, then set DLSS to balanced, else keep it off. Similarly, if you have an AMD graphics card, set AMD FSR to balanced or keep it off. Next, set anti-aliasing to TAA. Uncheck ambient occlusion and set depth of field to none. Click on apply to save the changes. Method 2. The next thing you need to do is update your graphics drivers. If you're using an NVIDIA graphics card, you can use GeForce Experience to update the graphics drivers. If you don't have it installed, download and install it from NVIDIA's website first. Run GeForce Experience. After you open the app, click on Drivers and check if any new drivers are available. Download and install it. For AMD graphics cards, the process is similar but uses the Radeon software instead of GeForce Experience. Run the app and check for any available drivers. Download and install the latest drivers. Restart your PC. Method 3. After updating the graphics drivers, make sure to close any unnecessary program running in the background. Right-click on the task bar and select Task Manager. In the Processes tab, check for any unnecessary processes. Right-click on them and select End Task to close them. Apps like Discord, GeForce Experience, Google Chrome, and NVIDIA ShadowPlay are some that you should close before playing games. Method 4. Another thing you can do is set the game to high performance from settings. Press the Windows plus I keys to open settings. Click on System and then select Display. Scroll down and click on Graphics Settings. Click on the Browse option and head to the Baldur's Gate 3 installation folder. Select the BG3 EXE and bg3_dx11.exe and add them. You will now see them here. Click on Options and select High Performance for both of them. If you don't know where the Baldur's Gate 3 installation folder is, then open Steam and click on Library. Right-click on Baldur's Gate 3 and select the Manage option. Click on Browse Local Files and this will open the installation folder. Open the Bin folder and here you will find the .exe files. Remember the address and use it to browse in the graphics settings. Method 5. If you're playing the game on a laptop, then change the power settings to high performance. Type control panel in the search bar and select the top result. Set view by to large icons. Click on power options. Expand show additional plans. Select high performance. Now run the game. So that's it. Subscribe to our channel and get quick solutions to all your tech issues. Leave a comment and help others know which solution solved your problem. Thanks for watching and always remember that we are here to help you out.